The next question is from a sister. After 15 years of marriage, my husband discovered that as a revert, I cannot be like all the women of his country of origin. For this reason, he started to object everything from small to big that I do, that I wear, my beauty and everything. After all, obviously, he wants another wife. I'm very upset, not for another wife, but more for his behavior with me. Should I accept everything without any objection?
Well, this question is, yeah, it has many angles to look at. First of all, with all due respect, whether you accept or you don't accept, he's going to do whatever is on his mind. So lots of men, unfortunately, are so weak, are so unmanly when they come to justify their desire to marry a second wife by putting down the first wife. This is not how men act, real men. Yes, if you want to make her feel sorry for you and for herself, you want to depress her, yeah, this is the right way of doing it. But if you are a real man, you don't do this. You don't hurt your spouse for so many years for just a reason like that. And with all due respect, even if you reject or you object, it wouldn't make a difference because he's going to do it at the end of the day. So what to do? I'm not promoting my marriage counseling sessions, but you guys know that I do this. Alhamdulillah, I'm very expensive. I charge $200 for an hour, half an hour for $100. But I'm telling you, I wish I could do it for free. Alhamdulillah, people are benefiting out of it. Yani, I can see that in advising women and a lot. And I get a lot of brothers on their own calling me, seeking advice regarding second marriage or divorce. And I can see that they're benefiting, alhamdulillah. Some of them come twice, three times, six times, over and over, seeking advice, seeking counseling. So if you can get your husband to speak to me alone, I will give him a piece of my mind. My problem is that when the two come together and they insist that to have a counseling session together, and I tell them, this is not good. The moment the man opens his mouth, I know he's wrong. So now what to do? I have to scold him. I have to say, Akhi, be a man. What you're doing to your wife, you don't accept anyone to do to your daughter or your sister. What is this? You're not a real man. I can't say that in front of his wife as if I'm telling his wife, why are you with this bag of trash? Divorce this so-and-so. Ditch him. He's not worth being with. I cannot do this. And likewise, when the woman opens her mouth and I say, you don't fear Allah. You don't need a husband. You need a mule to ride on. What you're doing is not acceptable. But I can't say that while her husband is listening, because Shaitan would work said, yeah, the Sheikh is right. Why am I staying with her? I divorce her. The best is to have one-to-one alone so I can give each one a piece of my mind and give them proper advice without the other one listening. So my advice to you is, first of all, ignore his abuse. If someone says you're a donkey, that doesn't mean that you will grow ears and a tail. It's just a statement he says. I know myself. So many people said to me, you are an ass. This is my name. Ass, I am. A-double-S-I-M. This is how they spelled my name when I was young. And it stuck with me. So people say, what is this ass talking about? Do you think I'm going to be offended? Then, unfortunately, you're wrong. I know myself. No matter what you say about me, I could care less. I have thick skin with the grace of Allah Azza wa Jalla. So you should have the same skin. Whatever he says, ignore him. Your beauty, you know that you look at his belly. He can't even see his toes. Look at the smell of his mouth. Look at how he looks. He doesn't look at himself in the mirror before criticizing people. And this is why I'm telling you, ignore his abuse. Try to live in the best manner for your family, for your kids. Life is short. You and I have only a few days left. Then what? Then it's paradise, inshallah, forever. And paradise is not given except to those who are tolerant, who are patient, who are doing what pleases Allah, not what pleases shaitan or pleases themselves or the others. So I hope this may comfort you a bit and help you, and Allah makes it easy for all of us.